Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion Angular Sidebar component in an Angular application.
I will also demonstrate how to configure a few of this component's basic features, such as toggling, configuring the dock state, changing different sidebar types, and integrating it with other components. The Syncfusion Angular Sidebar is a component that provides a site container for navigation and additional content on web pages.
Let's start with the application creation process. First, I initialize my app using the Angular CLI.
I will use VS Code as the editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. In VS Code, I install the CLI tool globally using the command npm install global Angular CLI.
Then I create a new Angular project using the ng new command and provide the app name, my Angular project.
I'll be asked to add Angular routing. I enter no and I choose CSS as the stylesheet format. I navigate to the location of my project.
To start using the sidebar component, I install the navigations package using the command ng add Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Navigations.
Before going any further, I need to register the Syncfusion license key. I open the main.ts file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the Angular trial license key.
From the 2022 Volume 1 release, the trial license key is mandatory for Angular products to avoid a licensing warning.
To see where to generate a trial license key, check the description below. Next, I navigate to the app module page, where the sidebar module has been imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Navigations package and registered in the imports array of the ng module. I don't need other modules, so I remove it all.
In the style.css file, the material theme styles have been added. Next, let's see the design that I am going to use in the video, which includes the header, main content, and sidebar.
In the appcomponent.html file, I replace the default code snippets with a few division and span elements with a header and the main content.
Within this division element, I add the sidebar component using the EJS sidebar tag with the width property. Then, I add a division tag as a child element and add content as sidebar content inside that element.
For better alignment, I define some CSS styles such as background, text, and font alignment for these division elements and sidebar within this style section.
You can refer to these styles in the GitHub sample provided below.
Now, I will run this example using the command ng serve.
You can see the output page is a simple web page layout with a header, the main content, and the sidebar.
By default, the sidebar component is positioned on the left side of the page. If you want to place the sidebar on the right side of the main content, add the position property and set its value to the right. Now the sidebar is on the right side of the main content.
Next, I am going to explain how to add a menu button to open and close the sidebar.
First, I install the Syncfusion button package using the command ng add Syncfusion EJ2 Angular buttons.
You'll all know that the module file is automatically updated when the buttons package is added.
Now I add the span element with inline style, float left, and then add the EJS button component with the CSS class property to set a custom style for the button. To set a menu icon for the button component, I add the icon CSS property and set the class names, eIcons, and eMenu. I change the position of the sidebar component to the left. I also define a few CSS styles such as border, font, and margin styles within this style section to align the button. The menu button has been added to the left corner of the page. Next, I will demonstrate how to open and hide the sidebar component using the button I just added. To do that, I add the click event with the appropriate callback method menu button click for the button component. I declare this method here. Then, I define a Boolean variable, toggle sidebar, and set its value to true. I bind this variable to the isOpen property to show and hide the sidebar and assign this toggle sidebar variable. Inside this method, I toggle the value of the toggle sidebar variable. Clicking the menu button now closes the sidebar component. To display it again, I simply click the menu button. Next, I will show you how to replace this sidebar content with the ListView component. To use the ListView component, I first install the Angular Lists package using the command ng added Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Lists. After the package is installed, the ListView module will be added to the App module page. Then, I include the ListView component code with a data source property. On the appComponent.ts file, I have added the list data object with fields, ID, text, and description. I assigned this object to the data source property of the ListView component. And I have mapped the data source fields to the list view using the fields property. To learn more about integrating the list view component into an Angular application, please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Since I'm displaying the programming language in the sidebar content, I have changed the button content to language and modified the main content based on the programming language. And in the style element, remove the padding top CSS style for the sidebar content. Looking here, the list is integrated into the sidebar and the main content has changed. I need to change the main content based on the list item clicked. To do that, I add the select event with an appropriate callback method, onSelect for the list view component. I declare this method here. Inside this method, I include the code to change the inner HTML of the main content with the selected list item's description. In the sidebar, when I click the language, its description will be changed in the main content. Next, I will explain how to display list view items partially when the sidebar is collapsed. First, I add the enable.dot property in the sidebar component and set its value to true. Then, I set the doc size to 72 pixels. While collapsing the sidebar, the list view items are partially visible. Notice that, by default, the sidebar expanding type is auto. The sidebar component supports the other expanding options, over, push, and slide. I remove the doc state properties to explain the types clearly. Let's expand the sidebar using the over option. To do that, I add the type property and set its value to over. Now you can see the sidebar floats over the main content. Now, I change the type to push. Take a look here, the sidebar pushes the main content area to appear side by side and shrinks the main content within the screen width. Next, I change the type to slide. See how the sidebar translates the X and Y positions of the main content area based on the sidebar width. In this video, I showed you how to configure the Syncfusion Angular Sidebar component using the Angular CLI tool and the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Navigations package. I also showed you how to configure a few of the control's basic features. You can download a working example of this from the GitHub link in the description for this video. I've also included a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.